Assalamualaikum, good morning students. I am teaching online from IYS school. I am your math teacher. So today I am going to teach you chapter number 11. This is matrix system of measurement. In this chapter we are going to learn about length, how to measure length in meter and centimeter from page number 114 to 117. So today we are going to learn about topic of the day are measure the length of object by using ruler, measure length in meter and centimeter, and relationship between meter and centimeter. So first we discuss what is measurement. Measurement are important part of our daily life. We need to find out measure length like length, weight or temperature, etc. Standard unit of measurement are used for measuring things. So first we discuss how to measure length in meter and centimeter. In old days, people measured length with the help of by their body parts. They use their feet, forearm and palm, but these methods never gave an accurate result. So nowadays we are using metric system of measurement. So what is metric system of measurement? Metric system of measurement is a system that most countries in the world use and agree on. Thus, in science only metric units are used. So we are going to discuss about how to measure length. So the standard unit of measured length is the meter, and many subsets of meters like millimeter, centimeter and kilometer. So we use millimeter and centimeter unit for smaller objects to measure smaller object, and we use meter to measure larger object. These are the conversion measure length. So 100 millimeter is equal to 1 centimeter, and 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter, and 1000 meter is equal to 1 kilometer. The word long and short are used for comparing length. There are different tools to measure length. We use measuring tape, meter rod and ruler. These are the instruments to use measure length. We use ruler to measure short length, and we use measuring tape and meter rod to measure larger length. This is a ruler. We use ruler to measure smaller objects. So you can find there are many divisions. Some lines are smaller, some are larger. So these larger lines show the number of centimeters. You can see here 0 centimeter, 1 centimeter, 2 centimeters. So these numbers shows centimeter. You can see here there are many divisions of centimeter. You can see there are small lines between two larger lines. So these small lines show division of centimeters. Now we will read the scale. This is the half centimeter. The distance from this is the 2 centimeter distance. And you can see here the scale shows 4.5 centimeters. Now we will learn how to measure the length of each object in centimeter. We use centimeter unit to measure smaller objects. So there are different smaller objects like pencil, paper, pen, eraser. So we measure the length of these objects through centimeter. Now measure the length of each object in centimeter. This is the paper pen. So what is the length of this paper pen? This paper pen, the length of this paper pen is equal to 3 centimeters. So we write here 3 centimeters. Measure the length of each object in centimeter. Here second object is paint color. So now find out what is the length of this paint color. This length color plays in 0 to 7 centimeters. So the length of this paintbrush is equal to 7 cm. Which object is this? This is the eraser. This is the smaller object. As you know that we measure smaller object in centimeter. So what is the length of this eraser? The length of this eraser is 5 cm. So we write here 5 cm. This is the pencil. This is the smaller object. And we measure smaller object in centimeter. So you can see here there are the numbers of the centimeter. So what is the length of this pencil? This pencil placed in 0 to 10 centimeter. So the length of this pencil is equal to 10 centimeter. So we write here 10 centimeter. Now see the another example. This is the marker. So you are going to find out the length of this marker. This is the smaller object and we use centimeter to find the smaller object. So what is the length of this marker? This marker is placed from 0 to 7. So the length of this, what is the length of this marker? The length of this marker is 7 centimeter. So we write here 7 centimeter. There are two types of ruler. The length of ruler is 15 centimeter. And the length of second ruler is 30 centimeter. So we find out the other object. We measured the, this is the 15 centimeter. This scale is long up to 15 centimeter. And we measure smaller object ruler. But a ruler cannot measure all objects. Ruler cannot measure all objects because the length of ruler is only up to 15 centimeter. So to measure the longer object, we use meter scale and measuring tape. So you can see here, this is the piece of cloth and the sailor. This is the piece of cloth. The sailor is using meter scale because we cannot find out the piece of cloth through the smaller scale. So the shopkeeper used meter scale, and the length of meter scale is equal to 100 centimeter. So 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. There are 100 centimeter in 1 meter. But we cannot measure larger object with meter scale. So we use measuring tape to measure the larger object. This is the measuring tape. And we can measure the length through the measuring tape. And it also makes less effort to make the length. So what is the length of this cupboard? The length of this cupboard is 200 centimeters. As you know that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter, so we can write here 200 centimeter is equal to 2 meters. Now you can see here this is the ruler, and the length of this ruler is equal to 15 centimeter. As you know that larger line represent the number of the centimeter. So 0 centimeter, 1 centimeter, 2 centimeter, these all are number represent the centimeter. And you can see here there are smaller lines between the larger lines. So these smaller line represent division of centimeter. So we use ruler to measure small object, and we use meter scale to measure larger objects. So a short ruler is 15 centimeter long, because you can see here the length of this ruler is equal to 15 centimeter. A meter ruler is 100 centimeter long. So the length of the meter ruler is equal to 100 centimeter, and 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. There are there are 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. So half meter is equal to 50 centimeter, and 1 upon 4 meter is equal to 25 centimeter. So 2.5 meter is written as 2 meter and 15 centimeter. 2 meter means 2 meter, and you can see half meter is equal to 50 centimeter. So we can write half meter as 50 centimeter. Similarly, as you know that 1/4 meter is equal to 25 centimeter. So 1 1/4 meter is written as 1 meter, and quarter meter we can written as 25 centimeter, because 1/4 meter is equal to 25 centimeter. So we can write quarter meter is equal to 25 centimeter. So 1 1/4 meter means 1 meter 25 centimeter, and 2.5 meter means 2 meter 50 centimeter. So I'm telling again, we use ruler to measure a smaller object, because the length of the ruler is only 15 centimeter. The length of the ruler is only 15 centimeter. So we use ruler to measure small object. We cannot measure larger object through the ruler, because the length of the ruler is only 15 centimeter. The length of the ruler is up to 15 centimeter. So we can only measure the short length through the ruler. And meter rod and measuring tape used for measuring larger length. Used for larger length, and 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. There are 100 centimeter in 1 meter, and measuring tape is used for larger object, used for measuring larger length. So a ruler can be used for measuring short length, and meter and measuring tape can be used for larger length. Can we measure larger lengths? So there is a worksheet. What you use meter or centimeter to measure the following. The length of your classroom is larger object. So we use meter or centimeter. As you know that we measure larger object through meter, and we use for smaller object we use centimeter. For larger object we use meter, and for smaller object we use centimeter. Number one is the length of your classroom. So what is the length of your classroom? Which unit we use meter or centimeter? Classroom is the larger object, so we use meter. So we write here meter, and we can write as, and we can show meter through small m. Number second is the height of your teacher. The height of your teacher is taller, so which of the following we use meter or centimeter? Which unit we use to measure the height of your teacher? For larger object we use meter, so we write here meter. The length of your pencil. Pencil is a smaller object. So for a smaller object, which unit you use meter or centimeter? We use centimeter because pencil is a smaller object. So we write here centimeter, and we can also write centimeter like. The length of your pencil is measured in centimeter, because pencil is a smaller object. So what is the length of your book? Book is also a smaller object. So we use centimeter to measure book. So we write here centimeter. And we can also use short form of centimeter. So the height of the board, which object we, what you use, the height of the board. So what you use, which unit you use, meter or centimeter. To measure the length of the board, board is a larger object, so we use meter. Because for measuring the larger object, we use meter. So we write here meter. We write here meter because the height of the board is a larger object, and for larger object, for measuring larger object, we use meter unit. So we write here meter, and we can also write meter as small m. So now you learn what you use, which unit we use. We use centimeter for a smaller object, and we use meter for larger object. So the length of your classroom is show with meter, with meter unit. The height of your teacher is show with meter, because your teacher is larger object. So for larger object we use unit meter. The length of your pencil measure in centimeter. The length of your book is measured in centimeter, and the height of the board is major in meter. Now we are going to learn about how to convert the meter and centimeter. Here question is given, write these length in meter and centimeter. Here first number is given 112 centimeter. So you will convert this number into meter and centimeter. So as you know that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. There are 100 centimeter in 1 meter. So first we write the separately 100 place. So which number is there in 100 place? 1 is in the 100 place. So first we write how many hundreds in 100 place. There are 100 centimeter. There are 100 centimeter, so first you will write 100 centimeter. Then you will write 12 centimeter. So 112 centimeter is equal to 100 centimeter plus 12 centimeter. So 100 centimeter, as you know that 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. You can see here. Here centimeter is written. So centimeter is a smaller unit and meter is a larger unit. So to convert smaller unit into larger unit, we divide the number. So 100 by 100 is equal to, when we divide 100 by 100, so we got 1. So 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. So we write here 1 meter. But we cannot convert 12 centimeter, so we write 12 centimeter as it is. So 112 centimeter is equal to 1 meter 12 centimeter. Now see the next example. Question number 2. 2 number is given 445 centimeter. So you have to convert this number into meter and centimeter. So 4 is written in the 100 place, so you will write these numbers separately. So how many centimeter in 100 place? There are 4 centimeter in 100 place. So first you write 400 centimeter plus 45 centimeter. First you write the centimeter separately. There are 400 centimeters. So first you write 400 centimeter, then you will write 45 centimeter. Now you will convert centimeter into meter. So to convert a smaller unit into larger unit, we divide the number by 100. So when we divide 400 by 100, we got 4. So 400 centimeter is equal to 4 meter. So 400 centimeter is equal to 4 meter. And we cannot convert 45 centimeter into meter, because 45 centimeter is lesser than 100. So we cannot convert. So we write 45 centimeter as it is. So 445 centimeter is equal to 4 meter 45 centimeter. When you convert this 400 centimeter, so you will write here 4 meter and 45 centimeter write as it is. So 445 centimeter is equal to 4 meter 45 centimeter. Now see the example number 3. In third, your number is given 305 centimeter. 305 centimeter. So we have to convert 305 centimeter into meter and centimeter. So first you write separately how many centimeter in 100 place. In 100 place there are 300 centimeter. So you will write here 300 centimeter. 300 centimeter plus, after 300 centimeter, which number left? 5 centimeter. So we will write 5 centimeter as it is. Now you convert 300 centimeter into meter. So centimeter is a smaller unit. To convert a smaller unit into larger unit, we divide by 100. So when we divide 300 by 100, we got 3. So 300 centimeter is equal to 3 meter. So we write 300 centimeter as 3 meter. And we cannot convert 5 centimeter into meter. So we write 5 centimeter as it is. We write 5 centimeter as it is. So 305 centimeter is equal to 3 meter 5 centimeter. Now you have learned how to convert length in meter and centimeter. Remaining part you will be complete in your book. Remaining parts you will be complete in your book. So today we have learned about how to measure length in meter and centimeter. So the unit of meter. So the meter and centimeter are the unit of length. So we measure, to measure larger object we use meter, and to measure the smaller object we use centimeter. There are different tools to measure the length. We use ruler to measure the length of a smaller object, and we use meter and measuring tape to measure the larger object. Now, note down your home assignment. You will do question number 1, 2, and 3. Page number 114 in book. You will be done remaining parts in your book. You will do fair work in your book. you will not do this work in your copies. First, you will make the title page of this chapter. You will write only chapter name and title page. And in book, you will do this question. Question number 1, question number 2, question number 3 in page number 114. Note down your home assignment. Again, note down your home assignment. You will do question number 1, question number 2 and question number 3 in page number 116. You will be do remaining parts of these questions in your book. So I'm going to finish our lecture. Our lecture is finished here.